Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuhu. Welcome to dua session. Inshallah, today we're going to start new dua, dua one. And let's see, let's start with the dua. Nahmadu wa nusalli ala rasulihil kareem amma ba'd. Fa'auzu billahi min ash-shaytani rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri. Wa ahlul uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli rabbi zidni ilma. So today's dua is dua number one. And it's there in Fortress of Muslim and also in Vayyaka Nasta'in. And this is in the morning, evening duas. Subhanallahi wa bihamdihi, Subhanallahil Azim. Could you please repeat after me? Subhanallahi wa bihamdihi, Subhanallahil Azim. So when we are saying Subhanallahi wa bihamdihi, glory be to Allah and all praise be to Him, only for Allah subhanallah ta'ala. Subhanallahil Azim, glory be to the Allah, the most great. So we are praising Allah subhanallah ta'ala. So when we are praising, so why is it so important that we should do zikr? It is a zikr, right? There are two types of dua. Let me tell you, there are two types of dua. One dua is like, you know, dua is an ibadah. You are asking, you are a slave of Allah subhanallah ta'ala, and you are asking Allah subhanallah ta'ala, like, you know, for example, morning evening duas, isn't it? What morning evening duas does? It's like a cover, it's like a protection, it's like a shield for you. I will give you an example, like, you know, if somebody is, you know, putting an arrow, the arrow will go back. It's like such thing, you know, if some calamity is going to hit you, it won't, because you are in the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are morning, evening duas. It's like a shield for you. Like, you know, when you recite morning, evening duas with the understanding of it, with the meaning of it, and if you make it a habit, definitely it will protect you. Because you get memorized and you will have that shield always in the protection. So we all, especially women, they always think, oh, you know, because of the Nazr-e-Bad, because of the evil eye, you know, I had this thing, and because of the magic or because of sihr, it's there, it's haq, it's truth, this will happen. Like how we believe in unseen, the same thing, but because it happened with Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how the last three you know, surahs reveal about the qul, and also it's mentioned in the Quran, sihr is happen, it's haq, and also, you know, evil eye. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he taught us many duas, and from morning evening duas, so we will have the protection. The second thing is dua e masala. You know, you have problems, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us, you know, when you have darar, you have some pain, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us dua. When you are traveling, he taught us duas, isn't it? So we have all different kinds of duas. And here, when we are doing this dua, Subhanallahi wa bihamdihi, Subhanallahil Azim. So when we are saying Subhanallahi wa bihamdi, hamd, what kind of hamd it is? Hamd is from ha mim dal. This is only, this praise is only for Allah subhanallah ta'ala. You can't praise the same way to the other people. If you are praising for the normal human being, it will be madh. It's not hamd, okay? Hamd is, you know, actually it has those qualities. Like, you know, Allah is Khaliq, Malik and Mudabbir. Allah subhanallah ta'ala created us from nothing. And He is Hayyul Qayyum. He is ever living. Is there anyone who is ever living? No. Everybody will die one day. Even the angel of death. But He is Hayyul Qayyum. And He is, you know, Malik. He is the one who owns it. He's the mudabbir. He's the one who plans. He knows everything. When a child should be born, when rain should happen, everything. So hamd is such kind of praise. So when you are praising Allah subhanallah ta'ala, Subhanallahi wa bihamdi, do it with the, you know, khulus, with intention. Pure your intention, clean your intention only for the sake of Allah. You are praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so that you attain the wajh Allah. the countenance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, if you have the such kind of good deeds, Allah will say radiyallahu anhu, Allah will get pleased with you. We want to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the only different ways Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has shown us. So this is one of the way, praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with hamd sana. And here, there are the few things, you know, first of all, with the, you know, renew your intention just for the sake of Allah. So when you are reading the dua, like, you know, first you have to look into the book and you recite it and read it and make it a habit to memorize it. And this dua, I'm pretty sure most of us already knew it. Just, you know, this is a reminder. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi subhanallahil azim. So when you are reciting this dua, you are praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you are saying, oh Allah, you are only praiseworthy. So when we do zikr, what will happen? You know, in Jannah, we all know that when we recite zikr, a plant will be planted there. So we want more plants in Jannah, isn't it? We love plants. We love plants in the world and we get the plants and, you know, in the indoor plants, outside also we plant it. So in Jannah also, we don't want barren land. We want more and more plants, okay? And in this context, a hadith comes. It's in Sahih Muslim. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu reported that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there are two words which are light on the tongue, but on the day of judgment will be very heavy in the scale. They are dearer to the most merciful. To whom? To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is very light, isn't it? Subhanallah wa bihamdihi subhanallah al-azim. And but it will be very heavily. We all want our scales to be heavy on the day of judgment. So recite this. It's very easy and very heavy on the day of judgment. And what are the timings we can do? There is no particular timing. Like, you know, as I mentioned, like morning, evening duas, you have to do it. Morning duas, like, you know, at the Fajr time, and evening duas at Asr time. But this zikr, you can make any time you are going to pick your kids, you are going to market, you are walking, you are preparing the food. Any time you can make the zikr. So, subhanallah wa bihamdihi, subhanallahil azim. It's not necessary that you should have tasbih, then only you can do, or you have to count it. Like, you know, if you do it any time, that's a good thing. But if you can do it on your fingers, it's nice. But sometimes when you're driving, it's really hard. But keep your tongue moist, saying, okay, this is the time I'm going to recite this zikr. And later I'm going to do this zikr. So let's end this session. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu.